good evening to all of you.
Thank you very much for accepting. Thank you very much for accepting our invitation to join and to talk to the participants of this webinar, as well as remaining other people, those who are watching this live. And the theme has been also very relevant and inspiration: youth and the city. So before maybe I can just present something short, and then I would request you to take over. Is it fine?
Please, most welcome.
Thank you. So here we are. We are starting the next part, which is the inaugural talk by Dr. Kiran Bedi, Honorable Lieutenant Governor of Puducherry. And I would like to also share with ma'am that this is the indication we have circulated this map. These are the participants, those who have the full registration form to attend both the webinar as well as the workshop on engaging cities. This is a bit close-up look of from within India, because most of the participants are naturally from here. Most of them are students, we have faculty members, we have professionals, self-employed, some people from government sector as well as NGO sector. And the overall theme of this event is working towards creating possibility and facilitating where our youth can engage, but with an ability or intention to transform. So create this kind of collaboration possibility, whether in a society, civic administration, educational institute, those who are part of the city, how they can more contribute to the city, students could be more engaged, and youth from all diverse walk of life. So it is from this perspective this event has been organized. And very short, you don't need any introduction. People are very well aware, and they are in a great admiration for you. You have been doing amazing work. I'm personally aware in Pondicherry, and I have been getting many messages from Prabir, particularly when he shares the photo. I'll just give you a very short brief. So Dr. Kiran Bedi became first woman IPS officer of India when I was born. So that is one way of putting how it was, what time, around that time, she was already the first woman of India to become an IAS officer. She holds master's degree in political science from Punjab University, also law degree from Delhi University in 88, and PhD from IIT Delhi's Department of Social Science. She had many other postings. I will not take much time about that. Many, many, a very illustrious career in the government, in administration, in police. And very few people may know, those who are not following this part, that she has been an excellent tennis player. As the national champion, she was eligible for the entry for Wimbledon Junior Championship. Why she has not gone, she can tell. I also read about that. She has been into social activism, and she has been Lieutenant Governor of Puducherry from 2016. So with this very simple basic introduction of rather very admiring personality, and the leader who has been connecting with the population all across, I would like to invite you to please share your ideas and inspirational message. Over to you, madam.
Thank you, Prabir, and thank you, Lalit, for inviting me to this webinar. Yes, this is my first experience as administrator, Puducherry, to look at the city as a whole. All along, having been a law enforcer, I had responsibilities of enforcing the law, be it in crime prevention, be it crime detection, in different areas. But this is the first time I did get the honor and privilege to serve the city as a whole. So rather than being theoretical, let me share with you my practical experience of what I've seen in Puducherry, which is very unique and original, because this is my first such responsibility. And what did I see missing? And how we tried to narrow the gap. And it did us good when we narrowed certain gaps. But in the first place, the gaps need not have existed at all. And the fact that gaps existed, who were the losers? Puducherry is an example. So therefore, I rather than being theoretical as a conceptual, I've overheard some of your speeches which were going on. It was here with about 15 minutes before this time, so I was hearing your concerns on water, water harvesting in particular, which has been very dear to me as well. I would say if I would give the city example, the Puducherry, what I did see personally was a large gap between administration and the people. And it was uncalled for. Who is responsible for the large? What was happening? Government officers were only selectively connecting with the people. Politicians were obviously connected with the people for the reason that they have to. After all, they've been sent away, they have to. But their reason was to be elected. While officers who came here came appointed, while the politicians came elected. Each one came on the promise of by and large, not development as such, but on dependence, not independence. It was dependence that we shall give you free food, we shall give you free education, and that we shall give you free clothing, we would give everything almost free. That was a very large section. So while the politicians came by and large, it's not that they did not have areas of development also, but majority was all about what can we give you free. Secondly, this was their agenda, and the social sector money was huge. Pension free, if you are retired, a little here, free. Student scholarship, free. If you belong to such and such caste, free. So it was a lot of freebies culture. And this is not unique to Pondicherry. It's unique to across the spectrum in India. And then there was a list who could be free. And this goes back to survey of 10 years ago, where people may have crossed the poverty line, but still get it free because they're part of the survey. And the next survey, not done yet. So therefore, it keeps them eligible. And you know how expensive surveys are. And people don't opt out. So they continue to get free rice, free dal, free rations, pensions, etc., and so many things. Everything free. So it is a freebie culture. Then let's look at the public servants. Public servants were not people dependent. They did their job 9 to 5 and with the heart and soul according to their own nature. They did it according to their own nature, their own inclination and their own priorities. And this city it's being out of the region, it gets young IS officers, young IPS officers, by and large very little experienced. At the top are some experienced, but by and large you get very many young officers here, very little experienced, because some start their probation and they get posted here, or they're young in age as collectors. They're almost like first such career in their assignment. So they don't have actually administrative experience. So they get hands-on as they are mentored. So but very few, like the chief secretary comes with a reasonable experience, and very few secretaries come with a reasonable experience. Rest of them are by and large very young in service those who have got rich experience, if they are very mentorship oriented, if they're mentoring oriented, they mentor the youngsters. But if they're not mentoring oriented and they want to restrict themselves to what is minimal asked for them, it's a minimalist approach, and they let the youngsters or the others work the way they want. And third area, which is the people. So here I've told you politicians, by and large, all the time, giving the message to the people that we are here to serve you. Of course they are here to serve you, provide for you, yes of course. But it was not a culture to depend on self-reliance, it was to sustain the culture of dependence. exceptions are always there, and worthy exceptions will always be there in this world, and they make all the difference. Again, worthy exceptions are even in public servants, where some are dynamic, they want to see change, they want to see transformation. So can the mics be off? Okay.
They have been calm. Please carry on.
Thank you. So I've explained that you had the youngsters and you had a history. Puducherry has an illustrious history of people who are still remembered. They are remembered. Oh, so-and-so came, he did that. He, the chief engineer so-and-so, used to be walking the streets every morning at 6 o'clock as city was clean. Such people are remembered. I also get that history back saying so-and-so did this. These are some of the good practices. Now the third category, elected category, appointed category. In between was a people category, like Probi Banerjee and Lalit and all of you, Lalit Varmas of the time, all of you, the Bangarus, all you individuals. Some of you were formed. You were formed as associations. You were formed as organizations. You had your little small NGOs, but you had limited scope. You could do that much. After that, you hit a wall because the politician was easily not available. The administrator was not available, or the people were not available, the secretary was not available. Third, you were not getting an appointment, you would lose time. So either you survived on your own, or you stopped contributing, or you let it be at bits and pieces. So I've seen a category, but as a society, as a union territory, you had your small NGO groups, you had your interest groups, you had in culture interest. You had your science, not much of science interest yet, but water interest, agriculture interest, water interest certainly, cleanliness interest. You had individual NGOs who were there and who would volunteer to do on their own. So, but there was no interconnectivity between the politician, the people and the publicly appointed person. There was no thread which was connecting the three. That, it, I think, is by and large missing across the cities in India. There was no volunteerism, a spirit of total volunteerism. Now let me go back to the movement which united us, united all the three by and large, is the Swachh Bharat movement, where it was seen, and that was the passion mission statement of Prime Minister when he took over, is that people must have their own toilets, as they were seen to be mostly going out on the in the fields. I personally saw myself in the year 2016 in one of my first field round into Valrampet Lake. I was on the ground, and guess what I saw? Nothing but human excreta all along the Valrampet Lake, and the Valrampet Lake reduced to a stream, and even that stream was being exploited out by a local dada who's extracting even baby fish out of that little stream, so that even the fish is not. And the whole Valrampet Lake had nothing but pigs strewn roaming around and garbage dumped on the banks of the Valrampet Lake. I was aghast. I felt very hurt. And I start to wonder, where am I? Where do I begin from now? Now, what was happening? Why did that Valrampet Lake at that time in 2014 become like that? A, it was exploited by the local political power. People who were on the edge, on the side, were using the grounds for human excreta. They were all very selfish on their own, trying to save any money for any connection, stealing water wherever it was, but they were surviving. So they were poor, and I can't fix too much on them. So there was a school close by, college close by. It had no spirit of voluntarism. There was no linkage to Swachhta. So people were using this brilliant, beautiful water body called the Valrampet Lake for their own... somebody's using the movie because somebody's saying, please stop. Radha Sen Sheroy, would you please stabilize? Yeah. So I'm just trying to tell you that how did we begin? So this is disconnected. Now, it's not a question of I story or my story. It's a question of inadequacy story, how disjointed Pondicherry was, which I saw personally, rest is history, how we start to connect with each other and work. But my question here is, we can put the blame entirely on the shoulders of the politician. But you and I know that he or she, you and I cannot change him. We elect them. We elect them. And we also don't have a choice in many cases, though we have a none of the above option. We don't exercise that. We go and still elect the same people who we know are not worthy of their jobs. But we still go and vote for them. When we have a concept called NOTA, I also am fully aware that the NOTA does not have a provision that if 90% people vote you for NOTA, you cannot be elected. He can still be elected. Even if you post a vote of NOTA, he or she can still be voted back to power. But the question is, why should we still not exercise? Because there's a moral authority. If you think that your area or people's representative did not serve your purpose, and it's a secret ballot, you can, don't share your mind, but go and vote NOTA. Let that person be elected with 5% people, 2% people. If he or she did not meet your municipal requirements, did not listen to you, was not honest with you, did not lead development to you, only created a sense of dependence, only land grabbed you, only allowed violation of the law, only talked about, never talked about economic regeneration, but all the time spending time in negativity, the choice is in your hands. So who are we complaining? We get the people we elect. And you cannot say, oh, I didn't elect him. Of course you did. You went to vote. If you post a voter, NOTA, and a majority voted NOTA, then he or she will not come back. At least he would say, oh my God, such and such constituency had 90% NOTA. Then you might say, but ma'am, we'll never get somebody elected. So be it. At least it lead to a churning. At the moment, what I'm noticing is that we as citizens of this country are going and re-electing the same people who we criticize while they are there, and also find have problems with them, knowingly proven. In fact, some of them have even got criminal cases against them. So this is the, as regards public servants, how do we deal with them? You cannot deal with them. They are not accountable to the people. I'm now giving you a reality check. It's all their individual self-driven intention, how much they want to serve you, whether they want to go extra mile or not. It's entirely theirs, because they're not, you are not writing their ACR. And Pondicherry people, places like Pondicherry, this is not Delhi, where you immediately get known and etc. This is far away. Television doesn't even reach here. National television has to make a special effort from Chennai to drive down here. And of course, as you see these days Pondicherry news are not even coming in the newspapers because of this, of the shortage of funds. Now the news is limited only to, so whatever you and I read in the papers today is Tamil Nadu news, because there's no space. Only the local vernacular is writing Pondicherry news, not others. So the point is, the public servant is not, and number two, that public servant has only come for 2 years. He's come for a year and a half. So how, what kind of emotional connect does he have? He's only answering his own conscience. He will work as much as he believes in working, wants to. And if he does not ostensibly get involved into act of corruption, he's fine, nothing will happen. He'll walk away with an A grade and go back to Delhi. As for Pondicherry, I'm now coming to the people. You said, what can youth do? You say, what can people do? I've been beginning from the beginning had said, please form an alliance of good governance in Puducherry. All of you subsume your egos, come together, Puducherry in good governance. Everybody comes together, everybody, nobody out of the way. If you come together, then you have an agenda for good governance in Puducherry. Problem is that many of us in the people also are government dependent for business, for grant, or for something or the other. You got a license, or you are having an irregularity, maybe an encroachment, or a multi-storied home. I do not know. But I feel people are scared. The only way you can get out of that scare is unity. United alliance. I have noticed that wherever people here got united, they got some result. They could speak up their case. Those who could not get united did not succeed. But there are two situations as far as people are concerned. One situation is where you are government dependent. Other area is you are not government dependent, where you can do things on your own. Now, let's identify as people of Puducherry, which are the areas which are not people dependent, which are not government dependent, where you don't have to wait for them. And number two, even if you are, supposing you got a good officer there, then he needs you. You can work with them. Now, let's take up, for instance, the beach cleaning. Who stopped anybody from keeping the beach clean? Nobody. You mean to say, if people had gone and kept the beach clean, would the municipality have come back and told you, why are you cleaning the beach? No. We could have kept the beach. I am not at the kind of beach revival we've done. You needed the government of India, the 30, 40 crores, and you got it. And that came through also public pressure, by the way. You have been able to revive the beach in Puducherry thanks to the people of Puducherry. And in that, Bondi Can and many others, and Orville and others have played a stellar role. See, you got the achievement. So somewhere where you can play an active role and you persevere, even if you took you 10 years, 8 years, so be it. If you keep on the pressure, it works. I'm only into that area which only needs your hand skill, your heart skill, and your own personal time. Puducherry, to my mind, youth can keep it 100% clean. 100% clean without the government interfering. How? Is if every youth group, youth for clean Puducherry groups are formed, and through schools, through colleges, and teachers are Puducherians. Or let's say, since I'm focusing right now on Puducherry, because it's good to give a concrete example so that one can relate it. If I have tried my utmost to get every Puducherry university student involved in Swachh Bharat, believe me, hardly 5% got involved. Rest did not. Rest wanted either a stipend or a transport free or a lunch or a packet free, etc. Why? Why isn't voluntarism integral part of their growth? Why not? Why should we be told to do this? This is because in the school education, we do not have a voluntarism as a part of education. First of all, as teachers, as schools, we need to have. Now again, you might just say, but that's a government policy. Okay, let's leave out government schools. What about private schools? If private schools come together for voluntarism, automatically the government schools may follow, but doesn't matter. I'm still at private schools who can form a consortium and say, what does Puducherry stand for? Clean Puducherry. Let's bring. Clean is so simple. Everybody respects their own areas. Groups of areas formed in their own neighborhood where they decide to keep Puducherry clean. Then they keep Puducherry green. From clean to green. And they can plant trees on their birthdays. They can have a movement. Now, you are not dependent on the government. You're not dependent on the public servant. I'm into that limited area. Just that limited area. Where we can set an example for the rest of the country. Clean Puducherry, green Puducherry. Now, let's look at water. What Probir and Lalit, you were all talking about it before I came, is on water. It's all in the hands of the villages. Now, in the villages, we don't have the panchayat system yet. And the reason is that there has been no public movement to bring the panchayat system back. It's more than 10 years you've not had a panchayat. So even despite Supreme Court saying, now it does not politically suit them to have this panchayats in place. It does not suit them politically because they become regular rivals. Now, but has Puducherry... Now, I want to talk about media also. There's a fourth pillar also, which is the public opinion media. I have seen media very selective. Just as you had public servants very selective in performance, I've also seen media also has very selective alignments. There are a few people who are neutral, others are also having aligned, and they would promote a cause and they would not. Therefore, you don't expect media to be on your side all the time. They will also pray. You can have a people's paper. You can start a newspaper of your own as Puducherry people. But you will have to subsume your own identities and not say, Mera naam chapani, Meri photo aikini, Mera mujhe credit. So as long as you're willing to have a shared credit, Puducherry will be the cleanest. As long as you have a shared credit, Puducherry can be greenest. As long as you have a shared credit, Puducherry will have enough water. How? Through the rural areas. In the rural areas, women SAGs are brilliant. Pass on this leadership to the women. They will take care of your water. They'll take care of your ponds. They will take care of the greening. They'll take care of the mental, because they have a personal interest in the ecological environment, because they are immediate beneficiaries. So I'm giving you a very limited answer to a larger question. I'm showing you the mirror. And such talks may not happen again and again. You may not have administration which is always connecting with open houses. These are all individual driven practices. What I have done, I cannot institutionalize it here by open up whatever has happened, whatever together we did. I'm not here to list out what I did. Whatever I did is a responsibility to have done, been done. My successor, maybe my successor does 10 times better things than I did. He's not bound by the past and he sets his own agenda, he or she. Therefore, what is permanent in this Pondicherry, what can happen, and you're not dependent on anybody else, is you, the people of Puducherry, where Orwell has wealth of knowledge. Orwell must step out a little and see what can it do individually and collectively. It needs to step out with its knowledge and its skill and see what can we do, even if it's done in a small way. There's another thing with people is, we always want to hit the sky. Why not look at the pond right before you? Why not look at the canal which is right before you? Why not look at the greening which we can do? Why not look at the beach and the cleaning before you? Why not look at the classroom which is right before you, where you can do literacy programs with the children once they're back home? Why not look at the way we do our cultivation, whether horticulture, wherever lands we are? Orwell, I've seen some very educational programs. Orwell must step out and make that education public. Educate the people, contribute to the, it's got a remarkable environmental education. It waits for them to, some of the wealth of knowledge which Orwell and Ashram has can contribute hugely to the growth, spiritual and environmental growth of Puducherry. But Ashram also is limited. Orwell has its own restrictions or laws or bylaws, I do not know. But nothing stops anybody from reaching. I'm not here in the criticism, I'm giving you only a reality check. And since you talk to me, what can youth do for the cities? I want to ask you, what can it not do? You are asking me what it can do. I would say, tell me, what can it not do? What stops them? What stops them? Nobody stops them to keep their neighborhoods clean. And then comes law-abiding. What stops them to be law-abiding themselves when they drive the scooter and a motorcycle? Why should they triple ride? Why should they ride without a helmet? Why should they not have a safety movement? Why should they not volunteer to say, we'll do it? Nobody will stop them. They can resolve, okay, if somebody else is not doing it, I shall. I will form a safe youth group and I will do it. I can do civil defense. I can do volunteering with the police, even if it invites you. If it doesn't invite you, so certainly you can't enter the police station also. I'm in a very limited role at the moment. Do, my concept is, do what you can do. Not find out, I can do provided I am helped. I can do provided I have money. I can do provided I have a policy. I can do provided he comes and shows me the way. No, I will do what I can do within my limited capacity. You may not have money, But you have time. Time is energy. And with your own time and hands and coming together, I have noticed great spirit, love for nature in the people of Puducherry. They love nature because it's a very gifted place here. And therefore, people would love to do it. Combine village groups, start training people in converting their garbage into manure in the villages, whereas it's not. We don't train, and we look at where's the government. Now, some places you might get a project. You may not get a project, but dedicate yourself, pass on this knowledge to the people so that they can benefit. So I am on very limited. I have explained to you and I've given you what we can do. The moment I start getting, but the government should do this, the politics, I'm not that. I'm not here to answer for them. I am only here to answer your question. Can the youth do better? I say, what is not that what the youth can't do? You can make the Puducherry cleaner. You can make the Puducherry greener. You can make the Puducherry safer. Safer also by your own conduct. Stop being rowdies yourself. The youth is providing rowdyism in a big way for as self-employment. Youth can learn personal skills. Today it's available, professional skills available online. You can learn online courses if you want to. If you don't want to do it and remain unemployed. And then the way we educate ourselves. We don't skill ourselves. We don't use our hands on our own. We're looking for a job. Constable's job. What about your skill? Oh, I've done a graduation. But graduation, what skill? I don't have any skill. Then how will I get to give you a job? Because I want something in return. So I think these are my opening remarks. What we've done in Pondicherry, as I told you, whatever has happened, again has happened through public movement. Whatever has been achieved, whether Pondicherry became water rich, thanks to the people of Pondicherry. It became greener, thanks to the people of Puducherry. Because now here it made life easy for you because you have the governor house and the public servant attached. Municipalities start to work with you, agriculture, people start to work with you. But what if it hadn't? What if it hadn't? We would have been dry by now because that, like, voluntarism. Now look, this is one area I want to leave as a thought and a closing thought with you. This year, the Secretary PWD has taken his individual initiatives and has been involving the machinery to clean up your drains, etc. He did that. Because of COVID, I couldn't just move out at all. I got restricted here because I cannot afford COVID Rajnivas to be closed as and quarantined, because then otherwise administration will suffer. So I have myself made captive, voluntarily captive, to see that Rajnivas remains safe, to continue to administer and lead, because you cannot have an army without a general. Unfortunately, I'm in that position of a general. And the general has to remain at the head of the army and step in and lead the war if needed. At the moment, I am behind it. But if I need to be, I'll be ahead of the war. And I do step in ahead of the war in many of my evening conferences. That's my role. I'm not doing anybody a favor. So what I'm saying here, but by and large, since I'm not, the current CPWD has done. But last 2 years, today you have water because you had paid machinery at the cost price by those shopkeepers who had the earth moving machines. They came, gave at a reasonable price and cleaned up our canals. And that is how last two rains you could store water in the irrigation canals. Had we not done that last 2 years, we would have been dry by now. But dry. This year, I think hopefully, but you need to now work on area. Adopt a canal. Adopt a pond. Adopt a canal. Adopt a pond and see whatever by human effort you can do. Once you put in a human effort, you can go back to your politician, you can go back to the elected representative, you can go back to the public servant, say, I have done this, we need this. If he or she does it, you've done it. If he or she has not done it, write to him, email, send him a message, connect with him so that you get it. I think not a July month should be immediately reviewed with important channels and irrigation canals. Are they ready? Have they been desilted enough? So that when the rains come, the monsoon comes in September, October, are they going to improve in their carrying capacity or not? Because last 2 years, we had public-private partnership, donor-driven, paid-in-kind machines. What is happening now? You need to have a plan. So Pondicherry people need to come together again and become a council. Become a council, and the council should change every year. Nobody permanent in that position. Presidents are not permanent. This is the 1 year council. Half the council retires, second, like the Rotary Club. Rotary Club, rotational. You have the presidents of the group. Give it to the youth. Give it to the youth. Say, seniors will lead you from back you up. You give the youth, the moment you give youth the responsibility, a sense of belonging will come. And you will see the kind of energy and dynamism. So it's important that the seniors take a back seat and tell the youth. But even in the youth, 2 years. Selected 2 years. First year, you go. Second year, half of them stay, half go. Nobody more than 2 years. So no monopoly. Everybody gets a turn like the Rotary Club. And that was why you've seen Rotary Club survive, the movement survive till now. Because there's no birthright to go on forever. So if we can get into these kinds of rotating leadership amongst the youth, Pondicherry is guaranteed to remain clean, guaranteed to remain water, guaranteed to remain safe, and you will have politicians join hands with you because you are a vote bank now, you have goodwill and they want you, they will come to you, you won't have to go to them. Public servant, you can then come in and they might appreciate you because there are nice people also who are very happy with such like things, so we will join you. But you are no more dependent on the public servant or the people's representative. You are self-dependent, self-reliant, and you are taking up as much as you can do on your own. So market associations should help you. Offer the machine. You can pool in funds, pay for the POL, pay for a driver's cost and get the irrigation. If the PWD allows you to clean up the irrigation. If it does not allow, I think then the group pressure must work. Why are you not allowing this to work without government money? It's no cost to you. So you see, in unity strength, you are not united. Puducherry people, as a people, you are all into wonderful think tanks. You are separate groups. Your centers of influence, your centers of power, you're bright in your own, but you're not united in an alliance. And that too, the youth, as I told you, you have to come and go and allow the others to come so that there's a rotational leadership. If you want Puducherry, a future in Puducherry, which is independent and yet interdependent, you're dependent yet interdependent, you will see the change. Puducherry will become a unique city, such a small place. It's possible to self-administer. This I thought I could share with you as my observations, as a reality check. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am. It was very, very inspiring and encouraging. And I think you really highlighted the core point that youth needs to be engaging first with themselves and with their surroundings. The message is very loud and clear. And this is, let us say, very small, humble effort in the similar direction. So I'm from Auroville with my architecture and planning background. I have been living and working here, and Auroville has got quite a lot. So this is an effort to reach out to the youth. We have almost close to 85 participants in this workshop, and there are more people, those who have joined this talk today. So idea is to see how people coming from diverse background start observing and taking part. The quality of engagement is the key. This is what Auroville has also taught us. So how to work towards the engagement, not only just keep on acquiring knowledge of a particular subject. So I think this message comes across very clear and very loud. Thank you very much. Very inspiring indeed. We can take some questions. There are some questions in the chat box. Would you like me to read some of them?
It says, let me, can read some. Let me see.
Sure.
There's a question from Bujal Varia. It's a long question. I'll read it. Some environment loving people and nature club members volunteered and gathered themselves and tried to save green open swing city like lake and joggers park, as Kiran Bedi ma'am said, self-awareness in people. Thank you, ma'am. Really, it's very inspiring. So she's endorsing. he or she, Bujal Varia, is endorsing what I said. Yes. And right, absolutely. Exactly, adopt absolutely. A park, adopting a park, adopting a beach. Ashwini Kumar says, dear madam, what are ways to motivate and organize people better at Citizens Forum and to ensure the safety in view of the police plays in hands? No, no. Again, you're finding dependence. Just start small. Look at your own street. Look at your own neighborhood. You want to cover the whole city? No, no, no. Begin with your own city. Begin with your own place. Start with that small. I know somewhere the police will support you and somewhere the police may not support you. It doesn't suit them. So you'll have all kinds of people in this government. So begin small and keep making the effort. Then says government has a lot of hierarchy when something needs to be. This is a Chamundeshwari case. Government has a lot of hierarchy when something needs to be implemented, takes a lot of time for approval. What is your take on this? And of course, I've already said they are hierarchical and therefore you don't lose time, but you don't develop your hierarchies. You create your own activism groups and let the work be divided and start performing. Then you have open defecation, a major issue all around the Bajaj Shirpur Bauri in Gurgaon. It's strange to see that the well that is considered sacred is also used as dumping and defecation ground. I think for this, you need to surround it. You need to surround it. Make a video of it today. Social media, put it on social media. Put it on social media. You have an immediate attraction. Today, social media is your immediate attraction. It embarrasses the government every year. Use social media. During my time, earlier time, we never had the social media. Today, what is wrong in a particular sage, whether it's garbage or it's a lake like this or a park like this, put it on social media. Ask the government. Government will immediately respond to you. So social media can be used for tremendous amount of activism. Then, question from Facebook. Even the village I'm staying currently, village which has 450 families not following Swachh Bharat for nature calls, despite Sarpanch producing toilet, providing toilet for each family. This village just mobilized the youth. We developed a whistle-blowing youth. We here in Pondicherry trained a few children, gave them a yellow whistle, called the yellow whistle. So these children would follow the person who is going in the open defecation and start blowing the whistle when he's sitting and doing a toilet. And he started to blow the whistle. So the man picked up his lungi and drove back to the toilet. So you can design a youth children's movement called blow the whistle. So they start to blow the whistle outside nearby where the man was sitting and doing open defecation. It worked. So we can do some creative movements. Madam, last year we came with the delegation of Institute Town Planners during, this is Pradeep Kapoor. Valedictorian was delivered by every participant, appreciate your effort. Then connecting common man. Thanks. Oh, it's a gratitude. Thank you, Pradeep. Lalaji, it would be good if others mute their videos as well. Bandwidth. No. Yeah, I need to connect with you.
This is from before.
Because I need to see you, because it helps me connect with you. Otherwise, I'm talking to a blank wall.
Yeah.
Dear ma'am, please emphasize on role of university. University is a gold mine of youth energy. I would think if every 1,000 of these Indian universities, every youth adopts a spirit, an hour of volunteerism, I think they can be the biggest transformers of greening and cleaning India and water rich. And they can have a lot of herbal cultivation. They can also become self-reliant. That means 1,000 vice chancellors can create the magic. Then Manju Arjun says, I am a professor in Midas Architecture. We have documented entire Pondicherry as urban design, and if you are interested, we can show the proposal and issues. And issues are archived. Sure, put it on the social media, send it to Pondicherry, let everybody get to see. Dear ma'am, please emphasize the role of you. I've already said. Can you please think? Harsh Kumar, Harsh Sharma. Put your message on it. Harsh, please put your question. Then Vijay Pratap Reddy, Rotary has the culture of adopting villages. That's right. That's what it is. You have the Lions, you have the Rotaries, you have the YMCs. You have these groups adopting villages. Ideal would be schools could adopt, as our own Kanagan Lake has been adopted by a conglomeration of schools and NGOs. If you can do that, it saves. And Cunningham Lake revival around it has happened because of this group. Prabhbedi. How can the ponds and other such water bodies be prevented from being encroached upon by land mafia? By doing social media. Picture them. If it is done, raise the questions. I think social media can be the best weapon to save the society, to save nature. Use the power of social media. Send it to chief ministers, secretaries concerned, LGs. Send it to social media, WhatsApp groups. Send it to them. It works. Put it on their Twitter handles. Put it into their Facebooks. It will work. Naming and exposing helps. Government, if their government take up some activity against environment, and if we protest, they book a case on us. No, your protest should be in a different way. Your protest need not violate the law. Your protest can be just start self-helping yourself and put it on social media again. Put it on mygovernment.in. It even goes up to the Prime Minister. It travels around. But remain polite. Don't become rude. Don't become arrogant. Don't take law into your hands. Don't give a handle to them. But use the tools of exposure. Do you agree? If the statutory bodies of various education should mandate a social skill based on activity. Yes, absolutely, I agree with you, Dr. Deepthi Pandey Rana. If all the schools, I'm looking at the government schools, I'm looking at the private schools. If the private schools, which they can design their own policies and have the PTAs, Parents Teacher Associations, associated with them, their children will learn voluntarism at a much younger age. So when they come to college, they will volunteer voluntarism. Any other? Lalit?
Looks like these are, there are some more.
Yes, but I have my deadline.
If you just scroll down, but depends when you want to stop.
Yes, I have a deadline of 4:45.
So then we are within that.
Yes. Harsh Sharma wanted to say something. He's raising his hand. Can you allow him, Lalit?
Yes, just for a short message, Harsh. Very short.
Jayendran?
Yes.
Hello.
Please
go
ask.
Ahead, please.
Jayendran, आप जनता के लिए तो बहुत अच्छे प्रशासक रहे ही हो और इसका अपने फैन और फॉलोअर से जैसे आप जुड़ रहे हो तो ये दर्शाता है कि आप बेस्ट गवर्नेंस और आपके द्वारा बेस्ट गवर्नेंस को प्रोवाइड की जा रही है आपके यूपीएससी एस्पिरेंट को जो आपकी तरह सूचित करना चाहते हैं आप उनके गुरु हो मैं ये पता करना चाहता हूँ कि अभी जैसे आपके पुदुचेरी के 4 साल पूरे हो गए हैं तो सेकंड आज आपका क्या काम है
आप 4-5 हो गए क्या बोला आगे
Harsh, what was the last line?
मैम ये बोल क्या पुदुचेरी 4 साल कंप्लीट हो गए तो आपका चक्कर आने क्या प्लान है
आगे का प्लान ये घर जाना है मुझे घर जाना है अब मैं जैसे 5 साल पूरे होंगे मैं आशा करती हूँ मुझे मेरी सरकार घर भेज देगी मेरे घर मुझे जायज 5 साल हो गए
Very okay. Short intervention.
Yeah. Ma'am, I'm an urban planner as well as a Rotarian. So I'm keen that you come and give us a talk in the Rotary platform. How can I get connected with you?
Do a virtual. Mr. Kedarnath, do a virtual conference at Rotary. Connect with my ADC and we'll find the time for you.
Okay, ma'am. Sure. Great. Thanks a lot, ma'am.
My pleasure.
Thank you very much, ma'am. It has been very, very inspiring and very positive and very direct. You have been very candid and gave very clear, direct message for youth. And whatever effort was being made here, even just to see how youth can connect, the message is very loud, very clear. That empower yourself, start working in your immediate surroundings, don't wait for other actions. And it is an energy, it is a fire. Ignite the flame, and I think one flame will light another, and this is the way we can start. We will learn the collaboration and we need to work together. I am very thankful and grateful for you, for your time, energy, and the sharing your experience, everything. And when things get better, maybe we get to see you sometime. Thank you very much.
Thank you everybody, Kusumlata, Paulumi Sarkar, Rajiv Sankar, Padma, Ramakrishnan, Srinivas, whomever I'm seeing here, very nice, Vijay, Kingal, yes. Lovely.
I would like to highlight, we have Mr. Srinivas, he was the former chief town planner of Puducherry, who is in Bangalore now.
Oh, I see. And see, out of interest, he's back again asking about Pondicherry.
Yes, yeah, I think Pondicherry is his love and liking and in the heart. So whatever happens around Pondicherry, he's always available to at least listen and connect to. I have been in touch with him, so I know him personally.
Iswakat Lalit, Pondicherry has had a lot of voluntarism. You've had a lot of youth movement. In fact, your water revival is all in the hands of children and schools. A lot of has happened. Lot of, now we need to consolidate it. As COVID recedes and people can get together, I think it will be time for youth coming together in Puducherry. And let the elders mentor, let the youth run it.
I fully agree. Even the team which happened, even the whole workshop, voluntarily came forward and the people, I think we are 3-4 male members, all are women members, and they are doing a fantastic job out of this. So I also agree that the women power can do wonder.
Yes.
They lead very well.
I would say youth power, which includes women and men. I would say youth power.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. And now I think over to youth in terms of leading their path, making their path further in their life for integral living.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Namaskar.